Hello everyone, welcome back to this session of Unix commands where we are going to cover some more commands like ls command, which command, how to find the manual of all the commands which we are working with. We'll also see how to work with the find command, how to add the users and working with the sudo commands. So let's get started and work with the various commands. So starting with the ls command, which is used to list all the files and directories in the current directories. We can also use various options to get in the listing in different ways. There is the which command, which is used to find the path of where the commands are located. So you can see it shows the path of location of the each command. So if you give which and the command, it will give the path where is that command located. Then is the man. So man is the command which is very helpful command, because it gives us the online help for every single command which we want to know details about that command. It also gives us all the options which we can use with those commands. So man is a very important command and a very helpful command, because it will list the information about each commands in Unix. Then is the find command. The find command helps in locating the files according to certain search criteria which you are trying to give. Then if you want to work with Unix, we sometimes need to add users. So for adding users, we can add the user using add user command, and then we can also use su command and the sudo commands. So these commands, like if you are using su command, helps us use to become another user during a login session, and using sudo command, you can act as a super user and execute the commands which you want to execute. So we'll just move to Unix and work with these commands, and then we'll get a better understanding of these commands. Okay, now we are in the dollar prompt. So let's just start with the first command which we just now discussed, was the ls command. So if we give ls command, it gives me the list of all the files and directories present inside that current directory. Now I can use if I give ls space minus l, then it is going to give me the long listing. Long listing means the details about of the files. It will give my like read write permission, how many links it has, who's the owner of the file, who's the group, how many bytes of memory it is taking, date of creation, time and date of creation. All these details we can get using ls minus l command. Now we can also use like ls and minus a used to display all the hidden files. So all hidden files are saved with the dot extension. How to create the dot files? Let me just clear it and show it. Clear. Now let me just create one directory. Let me create a dir one. And okay, it already exists. So directly I can go to dir1 if it's already there. Okay, so it is already existing, so I already gave cd dir1. Now I'm in directory 1. Now here let me create some files. So I can use the touch command to create some empty files. So I give touch and I give file 1, file 2, and then file 3, I can give file 3 and then file a. Okay, and then one more as file B. So I've created all these empty files. Enter. By mistake I give in the capital letter. So if they give the command in the capital letters, then it is not going to execute. All the commands in Unix is in the small case letters. So if I give in the caps, it's going to throw an error. Okay, so now these files has been created. How to check it? If I just give ls, I can see these many files has been created in the directory 1. So it is listing all the files. If I create directories also, it will list those directories also. Now I am going to create one hidden file. So how to create a hidden file? Cat and then starting with a dot shows those files are hidden files. So let me give this name as new file. Okay, and also I want to add the contents in that file. Hello. Okay, now I'll just close it. Okay, Now I'll create, let me create one more hidden file, but I'll use the touch command now. Touch and then filex. So again dot and filex. Okay, now let me just do ls. If I do ls, I can see that it is not displaying dot new file and dot filex because all the files starting with the dot extensions are hidden files and does not display the hidden file. So if I want to display the hidden files, I have to give ls minus a option. So now it is displaying all the hidden files also. The filex and new file also gets displayed. I want to find the long listing file minus l. So it gives me the long listing of all the files. By mistake I typed file. We have to give ls minus l. Okay, so it gives me the long listing of all these files which I've created. But again, the hidden files are not there. So for showing the hidden files, I'll give ls and I'll combine two switches minus al. So long listing along with the hidden files. So you can see now it is showing that all the hidden files also and the normal files also and the long listing. Now let's use something called as ls minus small t. If I give minus small t, it will be giving me the according to the last modification time. Okay, now if I give minus at, so if I give at hidden files and according to the last modification time, it is going to give me. Now I can also use ls minus r. So what does the r do? R gives in the reverse order by which the files are sorted. Okay, now so these are the options by which you can use with the commonly used switches with the ls command. Now let's just clear the screen first. CLEAR is the command to clear the screen. I clear the screen. Now let's jump to the next command, which is a which command. Now which, just now we worked with the cat command, so we can give which cat. It gives me the path where this particular command is located. So we can see that cat is located in the bin directory. Let's give another command, which ls command just now we did. So ls command, so all the commands basically are stored in the bin directory. We can see using the which command. If I give some environmental variables, which path, and then see. So sorry, we can't use. So it shows that it cannot use with the variable, only with the commands we can use the which command and the command we want to know the location, it will give us. Now let's say pwd. So it gives me pwd is also present. All the commands are present inside the bin directory. This is how we can locate. Now I want to know the details of any command. So let's say ls only. So man is the manual. So manual means it is going to give information about this particular command. So if I give, it is going to show me about the ls, what does the ls command do and what are the options and how these options can work. We can see using the ls, we can use using the man and the command. So these are the options. So if you keep on seeing, it will come. Now let me just go back to the command prompt. So for that we'll just press q. So man, and then you can give any command if you are not sure how it works. So if you just give man pwd, it's a listing with the information about pwd stands for print name of current working directory, and these are the options which we can work with. So if you keep on pressing enter, you get all the options which you can use it. Okay, now for control, for coming back again, we press q. Q is for quit. It comes back to my dollar prompt. Now let's use some other the next command, which is the find command. Okay, now I've cleared the screen and we'll be using the find command. So let me just see in this directory how many files we have. Okay, we have this many files. We'll create some more now. We'll use touch, and let's say we create a file name by the name as q1 and w2. These are the file names, and then r5, enter. Now let's create some directory also inside this mkdir and directory new. Okay, Now let's do ls. So I can see that there's one directory and the others are files. Let me create one more directory, mkdir, and let's create the name as dirs. Okay, do ls command again. So I can see this shows me the list of all the files and directories. Now let's use a find command. So I'll use let me just enter. Okay, do I have that command? Let me just, okay, I have this command. So find, and in the current directory, so find is a command which is used to find the like files and directories, and then using the options which you're given or by the criteria which you're given. So find in the current directory by the name of f, starting with f, rest can be any characters. We have used the while character start. Just press enter. Now it shows the list of all the files which is present inside that. Okay, now let's just create one directory starting with f. So mkdir, and here I'm going to give fdir1. Okay, enter. Now ls. Okay, let's just clear it now. Okay, now after clearing, now again I do ls, so it gives me the list of directories and files. Now I use the find command and then press enter. Okay, so just now we saw that we just displayed the files. Now let me use a call as l. Okay, now I use this command find in the current directory by minus type d. So I want to list all the directories. This is starting with f. So if I do, I get the name of the directory which is starting with f. The same command if I run, but instead of d, if I put it to f, so it will list the files. So if I use minus type d, it's going to list the directories. So starting with f, and the rest can be anything. And if I have means the characters should be f, and then rest can be anything. If I use minus type f, it's going to list all the files which is containing f character, and rest can be any characters. So this is how the find command helps us to find the various files and directories according to the search criteria. Now let's learn how to create the user, how to add the users to a particular login. So for adding a user, we use, let's say, add user is the command to add the user, and I give, and then I create one user, let's say user one, add user one. Okay, so it says only root may add a user or groups, means user, you have added a user, you have created a user, but only root may add a user. You are trying to do it, but it is rejecting it, because only the root user can add a user. Now I want to still add a user without changing my login, like I have logged in through gd, keeping the same login as gd. I want to still add a user, so I'll use a command sudo and then add user, and then what is the username? User one. Now if I do it, now you can see that it is asking for the GD password. So just give the password and then press enter. So if I give GD, then it doesn't show me the password. This is for security reasons. So it's already existing. So let's create another user, user 8, and then okay. So now it is asking for new Unix password for that particular user. So let's give the same password, user 8, and then press enter. Okay, so retype the password, so user 8, and enter. So now let's give any name, password, give the details of that particular user. Yes, enter. Okay, so I repeat the steps again. For adding the super user, you have to just give sudo and then give your the username. So add and then user and then user, let's say 9 or something, and then it will ask for password. So retype your password. After typing your password, it is going to ask for the details, which is your, like, retype the password, and after retyping it is going to ask all the details of that full name, room number and then is the information correct. You have to say why, so particular user gets added. So this is how you can use your sudo command. Now I want to change my user, so what I'll give su, and then I've just created user8. So user8, so it's going to ask me the password for user8 now. So now you can see that I have changed the login from GD to user8. So this is how you can add a user. You can switch from one user to another user. So I hope this concept of how to become as another user during a login session, and then how to act as a super user, these points are clear. So thank you so much for this session. We'll see other topics in